So now that we have seen multiple aspects of how caches work, let's summarize them for a more realistic cache. Let's say we have a 4 kilobyte, four-way set associative cache with a 64-byte line size, with a write back and write allocate write policies. The processor, let's say, creates 64-bit addresses to access the cache. When accessing this cache, the 64-bit address will be divided into offset bits, index bits, and tag bits. First, for offset bits, it's a 64-byte line, so we need 6 bits, bits 0 through 5, there are 6 of them, are gonna tell us where in the cache block we are. Next, we need to determine how many sets this cache has. It's a 4 kilobyte cache, that's 2 to the 12 bytes. The number of blocks is that divided by 64, which is 2 to the 6th. So we have 2 to the 6th blocks in the cache. It's a 4-way set associative cache, which means that every set has 4 blocks in it. So we divide the number of blocks with the number of blocks in a set, and we get 2 to the 4th, or 16 sets. Now we know that we need 4 bits to tell us which set we are in. So bits 6, 7, 8, and 9, 4 of them are the index. The bits that remain, bits 10 through 63, 54 of them are the tag. Now in our cache, we will have, for each block, a valid bit. It's a write-back cache, so we will also have a dirty bit. Then there will be a tag, 54 bits. It's a 4-way set associative cache, so we need to pick a replacement policy. Let's say the replacement policy is LRU. For a 4-way set associative cache, each block needs to have a 2-bit LRU counter. So here we have 1, 1, 54, 2, and then we have 64 bytes worth of actual data. As you can see, we have 58 bytes in addition to the data, so there is some overhead. The cache size is usually expressed in terms of how much data it contains, but the actual size of the cache array is larger because it needs to contain all of these extra bits for each line of data.